morning all, this is Himabindu from final BJC. I am studying in TTWRDC Kottagudem at Palancha. First of all, I am very thankful to our Praveen Kumar sir for giving this wonderful opportunity. And I am very thankful to our principal madam and all the lecturers for motivating me. Today I am dealing with the subject zoology and my topic is crossing over. Before going to this topic, we have to know what is the variation, what is the reason behind the variation from parents to offsprings. Why? Because it is the only reason of crossing over. What is crossing over means the interchange of chromosomal paths between non-sister chromatids of a homologous pair of chromosomes. It results in recombination of genes is called crossing over. This crossing over was first discovered by T.H. Morgan. Crossing over occurs in during meiosis of gametogenesis. The number of crossing over depends upon the length of the chromosome. When the longer the length, the higher the percentage of crossing over. When the genes are located distantly, the chance of crossing over is higher. When the genes are closely located, the chance for crossing over is lesser. The number of crossing over between two genes is represented by percentage of crossing over. The percentage of crossing over is also known as frequency of crossing over. First of all, we have to learn mechanism of crossing over. The crossing over occurs during meiosis of gametogenesis. No? So, in this meiosis, it will occurs in Pachytene 1 or Prophase 1 stage. The phenomenon of pairing of homologous chromosome is called synapsis. Here, the pairing of homologous chromosomes. These two are homologous chromosomes, no? So pairing here, pairing will be taken. It is attached by the center. Called this is center point called as centromere. So here it is called as bivalent. Sorry, synapsis. The paired homologous chromosomes are called bivalents, and these two paired homologous chromosomes, no? So it is called as bivalents. The homologous chromosomes split longitudinally. Here longitudinal division will be taken, and after this longitudinal division it forms two chromatids, each chromosome with two chromatids. Hence four chromatids are produced from two homologous chromosomes. This stage is called as tetrad stage. The chromosomes with the four chromatids, no? So it is called as tetrad stage. The two chromatids of chromosomes are attached by a single point called centromere. Here it is centromere. The non-sister chromatids of homologous chromosomes twist over each other. Here in this picture, it is one homologous chromosome and it is another homologous chromosome. So here twisting will be occurred. It is a X shaped position, no? So it is the X shaped point is known as chiasma. these two chromosomes are it is one homologous chromosome and it is another homologous chromosome. So these two non-sister chromatids are twisting each other. So here chiasma formation will be occurred. Chiasma means, chiasma is nothing but cross. At the chiasma, the chromatids breakage will be taken. Here breakage will be taken. So this breakage of chromatids will be taken by an enzyme is called as endonuclease. So the broken segment of one chromatid is fused with other chromatid, vice versa. So this fusion is brought about by another enzyme is called ligase. Here fusion will be taken by the ligase enzyme. And this process is called as ligation. The exchange of chromosomal segments between non-sister chromatids is called crossing over. Here crossing over will be taken, and the separation here should be taken. So the separation of homologous chromosomes or the separation of chromosomes will be taken. This process is called as terminalization. So this is the process and this is the mechanism of crossing over. Here some theories are discovered by different scientists. There are three types of theories. First one is chiasma type of theory, second duplicating theory, and third one is break and exchange theory. The chiasma type theory was first discovered by Johnsens. Here chiasma type means chiasma formation will be taken. Duplicating theory was first discovered by John Belling. Break and exchange theory was discovered by Muller Darlington. Next, types of crossing over. Here three types of crossing over are there. First one is single crossing over. In single crossing over, if one chiasma occur only at one point of the chromosome pair, if the chiasma occurs only at one point, then it is called as single crossing over. Next one is double crossing over. Two points in the same chromosome will be taken. And last one is multiple crossing over. This is single crossing over and this is double crossing over. Here in this picture two points, now the chiasma formation will be taken at two points, so it is called as double crossing over. And next one is multiple crossing over. If the chiasma formation occurring at more than two places in the same chromosome, so it is called as multiple crossing over. And next one is factors affecting crossing over. What are the factors? Means age, sex, temperature, radiation, chemicals, physical distance between genes. And here age, in age the capacity of crossing over will be decreases with increase in age and temperature. If the temperature increase, the crossing over will also increase. Here X-rays increases the frequency of crossing over. Some gene mutations decreases the frequency of crossing over. And the significance, what are the significance of crossing over? The phenomenon of crossing over is universal in its occurrence, and it occurs in viruses, bacteria, molds, plants, and animals, whatever it is, the living organisms. Crossing over helps in the linear arrangement of genes in chromosomes. It is very useful to construct the chromosomal map, and it produces the new combination of genes. It leads to genetic variation. And finally, it is the raw material of evolution. No? So, why it is the raw material of evolution means it gives the new characters, you know, from generation to generation. So, in each generation, the new character will be occurring. So, hence we will called as it is the raw material. It is the raw material for evolution. And it's over. So, thank you one and all for giving this golden opportunity to me. Thank you.